Hey everyone, this is Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to talk about Redbubble tags. Let's go! Thanks for joining me on this video, guys. This is the video about Redbubble tags. In this video, I'm going to talk about what tags are, why we need them, what kind of tags to use, how many tags to use. Stay till the end because I will show you a free resource you can use to see what the top Redbubble tags are for a keyword. So you wanna stay tuned for that, as well as another edition of Trend Credits. But first, for those that are new to the channel, my name is Juna. I'm a graphic designer, t-shirt designer. I design and sell t-shirts online. If that is something you like to do, make sure to subscribe to my channel. I put out at least 3 videos a week teaching you how you can design and sell t-shirts online. Don't forget to click that notification bell as well so you can be notified when my new videos are. So if you're not subscribed, please subscribe to my channel and you'll get all that kind of content. So we're going to talk Redbubble tags today. Before we get into Redbubble and on the internet, I just want to tell you what tags are. You know, you may be wondering, what is all these tags? What does it mean? These are what tags look like. You may be familiar with just all words and bubbles or multiple words. I'm going to break it down what tags are. Tags are to help people find your design, right? So you have the main title. The title helps you find your design, but there are also other words that can describe your design, and they're not going to fit into the title because you only have so much you can put in a title. So that's where tags come in. Tags are just descriptions of your design. So everyone should be using tags. Tags really aren't a magic bullet like a lot of people might think they are. You can get views from them, but remember, views are only part of the equation. You need value times views to get sales. So don't just think using tags, I'm gonna get so many more sales. What you may get is more views on your products, but your products still have to be good enough for someone to wanna buy it. That's what I mean by value. When somebody looks at your stuff that it's on page one, now you're ranking for page one, your product now has to deliver. Like, this has to be good enough for them to want to spend their money, and that's how you get sales. So you may be thinking, what can I use as tags? Well, here it is. What can we use as tags? This comes straight from Redbubble. You can use locations and full proper nouns. So like Golden Gate Bridge, for example, or San Francisco, those are locations and nouns. Color palettes, whatever color is in your design, pastel, fall, gray, whatever describes it as a color or color palettes, you can use that. Red, blue, those kind of things. The subject of the artwork, so what you have in your design, let's say zombies or soccer or penguins, those things that are in your designs, of course you can use that as tags. Techniques you've used, so if you drew this as a vector or a pixel, or use typography in a good way, those can be used as tags. Multiple words can also be used as tags. We had the example here, Golden Gate Bridge. Of course, you can use Grand Canyon, London Bridge. Those are two words put together, so you would put the comma after the second word, not the first word. And when you do multiple words, you don't have to do Grand and then Canyon again. When you do Grand Canyon as a multiple word, it will pick up for Grand and for Canyon, or for London and for Bridge. So you don't have to put London, comma, Bridge, comma, London Bridge, comma. You can just do London Bridge and that would be good. What you can't use, what Redbubble doesn't want you to use as tags, is they don't want you to type to describe the product itself. So you can't use like glossy sticker or 100% cotton t-shirt or things like that. That's describing the product. You want to describe your design, not the product itself. Words that don't apply, this is called tag spamming. So if your design is about a dog, for example, don't put a cat in there because it's not about a cat. Your design only has a dog. So some people like to put random words in there that don't describe their design, hoping that the tags will help them rank up on page whatever, but that actually backfires. Redbubble doesn't like that and you will get pushed down more and more. So don't do that. And then full sentences, you can do multiple words, but it doesn't have to be a full grammatical sentence. It doesn't have to be, you know, Grand Canyon. This is a picture of Grand Canyon in Arizona or something like that. So just put what it is, just short words, maybe multiple words, but not full sentences. You don't need that. And lastly, before we get into Redbubble, how many tags should we use? Redbubble recommends between 10 and 15 tags. You don't need to put a whole bunch. You don't need to put 50 tags in there, but 10 to 15 relevant tags that match your design. Now that we talked about tags and kind of caught up on what tags are, I'm going to go to the internet and show you exactly where tags go and how to find good tags. All right, so here we are on Redbubble, guys. I'm going to start typing in. I'm going to do a new t-shirt. I'm going to look for something that's trending. And I thought I saw one. There we are. You can see here the arrow is going up. No farmers, no food. I'm going to do a design for this. And then I'm going to show you what tags I use for this design and how I find the tags for this new design. So let me work on the design, and then I'll show you what we do and where we add the tags for a new design. Okay, so we're here on my No Farmers, No Food design. You can see right here, I used the vintage sunset, and yes, I used all sunsets for this design. If you've seen my other videos, you can see how to get that kind of design here. I'll put a link up there, a card up there. But this one's about tags, so let me show you what it says about tags. This is where you put the No Farmers, No Food. I saw that trending in the title, right? So, or in Redbubble. So I'm gonna use that as my title so that when people type that in, this is what pulls up my title. But like, I could put more tags here and add it to my title, but what I wanna do is actually add the tags here in the tags column. You can see here, even Redbubble is saying tags are how your audience finds your work, which what we talked about, and use 15 relevant tags per upload. So that's what we're going to do. The first way to add tags is just to think about describing the design. So this is brainstorming. This is just using what you have on your design. So first of all, of course, it says no farmers, no food. So I'm going to do that. No farmers, no food. I'm also going to add a vintage sunset because that's in the background. I'm going to talk about a barn. There's a barn in there. There's a silo. There's also the different colors that I can do. So red, do red and orange. And then another thing you can add is farming. So I'm going to add that. And that's kind of all I can think about right now. So let's see how many that is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, I spelled that wrong. Orange, 7. So I still have room for some more. How do I find more ideas? So I'm gonna show you how you find more ideas. I'm gonna close this for now. I'm gonna save these tags right here and close this. Okay, so after you used your brain and tried to figure out different tags, just brainstorming and describing your product, the other place you can check for tags is Redbubble itself. So here we are on Redbubble homepage. I'm gonna start typing in the no farmers, no food, which I used to create my design. So once I do that and I search for that, no farmers, no food here, and I search. And so this is No Farmers, No Food search. You can see there's some tags up top here, but if we scroll down, all the way down, there's also related searches, which are also tags you can use. So what I would do is take a look at these. This is more than 15, by the way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. You could use all of those if they relate to yours. So I'm just gonna, for me, I'm gonna just take a screenshot there and up here, also take a screenshot of this one so that I can save that for later and kind of just pick the best 15, right? So the next one that I'm gonna do is you can also look what other people are using. So let's see, this one is ranking at the top. At least it pulled up the first one, so it might be a good one. Let's click on it. Let's see what tags this person uses. So when you look at somebody else's design, you can see their tags, and this is for everyone. So on mine, it would show here as well, the tags that this person used way more than 15. So you can just decide which ones you want to use here. So I'm going to screenshot this one and pick my favorite 15 on here. So that's another way you can find tags, relevant tags for yours. And you don't have to stop at one. If you go back, and what I like to do is I like to look at the best sellers. So let's go here. That was most relevant. So I check on best selling right here. So these will be the best selling No Farmers, No Food t-shirts or stickers or whatever. So that was the best one. Surprise, they have way more than 15 tags. But let's find another one. No Farms, No Food. That's not exactly what mine says. No Farmers, No Food. Well, I guess it's close. Let's try it. It's a t-shirt. So let's click on it. So kind of the same thing. Let's scroll down, see what tags they're using. They also have more than 15, looks like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Wow, way more than 15. So again, I'm just going to, you know, take them all, not use them all myself. I'm just going to screenshot it so I can look at it later. So the last thing that I want to show you is a free tool to see what the best tags for this topic is. And for that, I'm going to go to a different screen. All right, so thanks for staying till the end here. This is the one that you might be waiting for. This is the Redbubble Tag Generator by Merch Titans Automation. So just go to automation.merchtitans.com/tools/Redbubble Tag Generator, and it's free. You'll have to register, but it's a free register. You don't have to pay or anything. Just put in your email and stuff. But here it is, Redbubble Tag Generator. And let me show you how it works. If you don't want to type all that in, I'll put a link in my description so that it's just easier for you. You can click on it. But let me show you how it works. So let's type in what we did before. No Farmers, No Food. All right. Make sure to type it correctly. So sorry, it took a little while to get the tags. It started running. I didn't want to just have you wait. But this is what happens when you get tags. You can see here, No Farmers, No Food. When I get the tags, here are the top tags that are used on Redbubble for that. So you can see it goes by how many times it's being used. Of course, there's way more than 15, but you can just take the first 15. I'm going to screenshot it again so that I can use it later. That's about 15 right there. And then I'm going to look at all those tags that we looked at, and then I'm going to pick the best 15 for mine, and then we'll go back and I'll show you where I put them in my tags. So here we are again at my No Farmers, No Food example. I have my tags here. I looked at all the different tags that I found using brainstorming, using Redbubble, and also using that Merch Titans Redbubble tag generator. So after looking at all those tags that I found using all those different ways, I came up with my 15 tags here. So you can see No Farmers, No Food, 1, Vintage Sunset, 2, Agriculture, 3, Farming, 4, Barn, Farms, Farmer, Protest, No Feature, Farmer's Daughter, Gastronomy, Farm, Food Chain, Support Local, Market, Sustainability. So 15 there in between the commas. And once I'm done with that, tags, I pick all the designs I want it to put on, and I come down here and make sure that I have the rights to sell this and save my work, and it's going to save it. And those are all the tags. So those tags will show up now when I look up my design. And so people will see what tags I use. It also will show up here when you see it, when you save it. And those are the 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So I got right in there what they said, 10 to 15. You saw that other people use more than 15. That's not what Redbubble suggests. You can do that if you want. Some of them were bestsellers too, so I don't know what's going on. That is it for this video. If this video really helped you and you liked it, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you aren't subscribed already. If these videos are actually giving you some value and you like these, don't forget to subscribe. And don't forget to stay till the end. We have another trend credits. All right, so here is the trend for today. What the Succulent shirt. You can see here, it's a pun on succulent with a F. You can see the BSRs here are very low, 20,000, 51,000, 65,000, and they are making sales over and over here. So people love funny puns, especially puns about succulents and swearing, I guess. So let's just check the advanced competition checker. So on Merchant Former right here, it's getting an A as well. So you can see all the other ones up here. So that is the trend for today. So there it is. And that is it for this video, guys. Thanks so much for staying to the very end. And if you haven't already, like and subscribe. And don't forget to click that notification bell again to get notified of when my next videos are. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. Till the next one, see ya.